Welcome back. Last episode, we finally finished Helyme. At least for now. Until we have to come back here for something else. It was Miranda's loyalty mission. So it was pretty neat. And now we get to explore the rest of this... the Crescent Nebula? Crescent Nebula, yes. Okay, let's go to, Zelene, then. We will map out these systems. Here's an iridium-rich planet. Good, because I think we could replenish some resources here. Four planets here. Nepema. Tidally locked to the star Zelene, Nepema has the expected hot pole and cold pole. Along the terminator is a thin band of nearly habitable terrain. Unfortunately, the local biosphere is based on a chlorinated oxygen atmosphere. It is not sophisticated, but it has proven highly dangerous. The Asari surveyor Viralis landed on Nepema in 1684 to study the local ecology. Unbeknownst to the crew, a handful of native chlorine-fixing microbes passed through biohazard screening and entered the ship. The Viralis returned to the port of Nos Paranello on Helyme, where the Nepeman microbes escaped into a temperate environment with plentiful unused chlorine. Doesn't sound good. The microbes devoured the chlorides in the earth as metabolic byproducts. They produced toxic polychlorinated biphenyls, PCBs. By the time the infestation was contained, an area of nearly 30 square kilometers had been effectively turned into a toxic waste dump. Nos Paranello had to be abandoned, accelerating the development of Nos Astra. Wow. Sounds like quite a messy business. Well, that came up quickly. Rich in stuff we need, I hope. Which is everything but palladium. I'm gonna not get any palladium. Doesn't seem to be a lot of call for it, and we have plenty of it.
Probe launched.
As it is. I think we have about enough of
probe away.
Iridium as it is. Alright, so let's just look for platinum and Ezo. We need Ezo. Doesn't seem to be platinum on this planet. Alright, never mind. It's an iridium-rich planet, so... not platinum.
I have detected an anomaly.
Oh, goody. Helyme is a post-garden world that once enjoyed an Earth-like oxygen-nitrogen atmosphere. It is still blessed with plentiful water, but a generally cold climate and extreme seasonal shifts, courtesy of a 38-degree axial tilt. Helyme is thought to be the homeworld of the Arthen, a spacefaring species which disappeared approximately 300,000 years ago. Precisely what happened to Helyme is still under debate. It appears a global extinction occurred, wiping out all native animal life forms more complex than zooplankton. Plant forms were not affected, but the lack of oxygen-breathing life caused oxygenation of the atmosphere. Plant life was reduced after lightning storms ignited global wildfires. The leading theory for Helyme's devastation is an out-of-control biological weapon. For this reason, landing is strictly prohibited. The corporations of Helyme have emplaced a network of quarantine satellites to dissuade would-be looters from landing in the crumbling cities. Huh. Well, we found an anomaly. Are we going to violate that? Moderate.
All units report to ready stations for possible anti-invasion protocol. Repeat, unidentified ship detected in orbit. All units report to ready stations for possible anti-invasion protocol. Detected in orbit. All units report to ready stations for possible anti-invasion protocol.
I'm gonna be invaded by somebody.
I have found something.
Mercenary activity detected inside a mining facility on planet's surface. Facility confirmed, registered to Eldfell Ashland Energy Corporation. Eclipse presence confirmed. Distress beacon powered down at site. Sensors detect multiple spacefaring vessel launches from facility. Alright, well, I'm gonna scan first. We're gonna check this place out last. After I look at the other two planets here. Oh, we got Ezo! We got an Ezo! Yeah, baby!
Probe launched.
We need that so I can learn Miranda's power. Her biotic power. I can now afford the advanced training. Good, thank you. Iridium, we have enough. Stand to have some platinum, though. Oh, yeah. And there's Ezo. The Ezo is highest here, I think, as well.
Probe launched.
Some more. It's not easy to find.
Probe launched.
Oh. I love the sound of the Ezo. High-pitched sound.
Launched.
If I could get up to 10,000 ESO, I'd be very happy. Was that some platinum too? A little bit.
Launching probe.
Oh. Always excited when I find it.
Launching probe.
No platinum.
Probe away.
More platinum.
Probe launched.
This is a great planet. Look, it's poor now. We're depleting our its resources. Just double checking for any more element zero. Depleted that off of there. Wait. Where was that? I just saw it go up a little. Oh, here we go.
Launching probe.
A little bit. We're done. We'll be back in a minute to land on the planet. Ifo is a rocky world with an atmosphere of oxygen and carbon dioxide. There are large craters scattered across its surface, obviously from hypervelocity kinetic impactors. Stretching between these locations are the shattered remains of magnetic levitation rail lines, which strongly suggest The craters represent the former location of Artheni mining outposts or other settlements. The equatorial region contains an extensive network of canyons formed by the planet's abundant liquid water. Travel advisory, FO's atmosphere is approximately 41% carbon dioxide at sea level. This level is 4 to 6 times that necessary to render most species unconscious within a few minutes of breathing it. Breathing masks must be worn at all times when on the surface of FO. EFO, whatever. It's very cold there. Rich in stuff. Nice platinum.
Probe away.
Okay, we're done. Oops. And finally, Galen. Galen is surrounded by an extensive ring system. The inner rings are composed of pulverized nano-manufactured carbon materials thought to be the remains of an Artheni Helyme-3 mining infrastructure. The few pieces of larger debris found indicate a materials technology at least equal to the current galactic state of the art. The outer rings consist of water ice, silicate dust, and the odd bit of rock. Analysis of the debris often show shock damage and evidence of rapid heating. Some para-historical theorists insist that the outer rings represent debris from a moon or moons destroyed by a mass accelerator bombardment. This has been rejected by every reputable xenoarchaeologist. While it is theoretically possible to destroy a small moon utterly with dreadnought bombardment, no species sees a compelling reason to do so. Moderate. Anything we need? I'm not pressing left mouse yet. Some platinum, apparently.
Probe launched.
Platinum? Not that much, but why the hell not?
Probe launched.
Okay, that's good. Okay. Let's investigate the Eclipse presence. I get to change her appearance. Okay. I'll change it, but I'm not taking her this time. How about Zaid? Been a while. Fighting mercs? Always fighting mercs, though, but. How about Garrus as well? Oh, goody. I'm taking Shockwave because I'm always using that. evolves into one of the following. Heavy shockwave, obliterates everything over a long distance, or improved shockwave, now has a wide impact radius, taking out everything in a broad strip in front of you. Not sure. Strengthens to become a biotic freight train, swatting aside everything in a long path. So that's a long path, and this is a wide path. Broad strip has a wide impact radius. Impact radius 3.50 meters. Impact force. Number of shockwaves, 12. Let's take improved. I just hope it's doesn't, you know, I hope it's not that limited to like right in front of me. I guess we'll find out. Can't be worse than it is. Okay. Can't level anything else on these guys. And they should be good with weapons. They always seem to be hanging out in these rusty metal things. No sign of him. Cargo computer. Shipping log. Cargo ship Ter Allen docked and received a large shipment of resources en route to a facility in the Dranic system. Sir Allen requested escort for the shipment, claiming pirate activity along the route. Okay. Yeah.
Taking cover.
Me too. Take cover too.
Deploying warfield.
Rather close.
There we go.
Who's next?
Oh yeah, I took him out. Cool. No. Crap. That surprised the hell out of me. Oh, still alive? No, right? Okay. Any more? Yes. These guys hide well. Well, she was still alive. I shot her again, too, and she just laid there. She didn't show up on my screen that she had any more of the life left. Any goodies? The lady surprised me twice. Which way do we go? Palladium. Not that we need it. Okay. Guess we're bypassing the door. Begins a bypass. Alert, we are under mercenary attack. Escort civilians to crew quarters, then return to the work area to protect the main computer at all costs. Apparently it didn't work out for you.
Grabbing cover.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it worked from around corner. Nice. Hit you? Is that what you're saying to me?
Eclipse forever.
Eclipse forever. Uh-huh. Eclipse for a second.
Some cover.
There we go.
Mm-hmm.
This should slow him down.
Not charging.
Concussive shot ready.
All right, so use it. Oh, that's you, Zaid. What the?
Moving to cover.
Okay. This is a warning. For now. Let's check out down here. More clips. Oh. I wanted to see if I could hit the med kit from here. I knew it wouldn't make sense, but... Hey, we got power cells. Under credits, cheapskates. Bridge control. I'm on the wrong side of the bridge. Hack the mainframe. Amber, green, purple. This one. That one. That one. Access granted. Location of last report from Tyr Allen. Encrypted. Decrypt. How long does it take to decrypt the frickin' thing?
Gonna blow your ass away!
Oh. Trying to decrypt here. Do you mind? Oh, boom.
We can
Throwing an impact.
Gotcha. Guys are right over there.
Firing a high impact shot.
Still reaches a pretty long way.
This should slow him down.
I'm not sure if I even had him targeted correctly.
Watch the fire! We've got casualties!
I've seen it.
Kidding, they've seen us. They've been fighting us the whole time. Being in one piece, thank you.
Get my mind on field.
Oh crap. Awesome. Someone back there. Was that Garrus? That's Garrus. Decrypting complete. Finally. The decrypted data is incomplete. Oh, you just said complete. Now it's incomplete. Further details are required to trace the Tyr Allen's location. The data has been sent to Cerberus for further analysis. Alright. Sounds like a plan. More clips down here. One more clip. Control. Oh, to end the mission? Hmm. Well, let's see if there's anything else around here besides things that explode in our face. Hmm. Cool. A That's the dish that we saw on our way in here. Any goodies? There's a med kit. Right, I saw this. Wow. Saw that from the other side. Okay. Press and hold. Sure. Quick little mission. Recovered data referring to the Tur Allen's location. More decryption needed. 125 experience, 15,000 credits, 2,000 palladium. Now I want to see if there's mail to see if we decrypted that stuff.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Good. I hope it's some good results here. Oh, it's from Oriana Lawson. I hope this is the right Commander Shepard. No, it's not her mother. I'm Oriana. My sister only told me a little, but I don't think it occurred to her that I'm as smart as she is. I poked around a little and found an information broker who got me this address. No, it has occurred to her, actually. She said that. You're as smart as she is. I got to thank her, but I never got to thank you for helping me. My parents don't really understand it, but I know how much Miranda did, how many little things over the years were her looking out for me. I'm not going to tell them. I still want to go to school and get some degrees, but I wanted you to know that I know you saved me. I had a guardian angel all these years. I don't know if my sister has anybody. She said that she's working for you, and it was pretty clear that you were doing something dangerous. Make sure she comes back alive, okay? Oriana. P.S. Don't tell her I sent you this. It would just make her angry. P.P.S. Miranda, quit looking at Shepard's messages. Oh, don't act like you don't. It's what I do. Hey, I don't look at my messages. Only I'm allowed to spy on you with the Shadow Broker base. Okay, so thanks for watching. Tune back next time when we explore more of this cluster that... whatever cluster it is that has the, is it a Crescent Nebula? I don't want to give incorrect information. So we finished mapping out this Zelene. Right, Crescent Nebula. We'll explore more. We've got at least two more systems. I think there's two more systems left. So thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.